So the attempt here is to strike a proper balance of making sure that our economy can function, we protect the most vulnerable, we slow the rate to buy us time and build out our capacity to deal with this. So significant mitigation that we're going to do for 2 weeks will reduce us from, will move us up from 50% interaction, stopping social interactions, to 80% stopping of that. We'll follow up by physical distancing, which we've already done, which is reducing it by 50%, followed by a physical distancing for the vulnerable. What this time we're buying will allow us to do in addition to the upping the ICUs, to standing up mobile hospitals, to providing more ventilators, more personal protective equipment, and more testing, will also allow us to identify people who should be sheltered at home for a longer period of time. So today, here's what I'm asking you to do, Minnesota. And my pledge to you is to use the valuable time you're giving us to build the coalitions, public and private, to produce those ICU units, to produce the necessary PPE that keeps our neighbors safe and drops that number of fatalities significantly. We're going to limit movement outside the homes beyond essential needs, effective Friday, March 27th at 11:59 p.m. to Friday, April 10th. And I want to be clear, there is no magic around a two-week period. We have weighed out the variables here. We believe at this point in time, as of today, that buys us enough time. We may ask or need to see what's happening with production lines to be able to adjust that accordingly. But we also understand those of you out there who have taken great pains in your manufacturing facilities to do social distancing, who have done great pains to pay your workers and pay their health care. We owe it to you to have this as compressed as we possibly can, to use the time wisely and allow us to move on. We're going to continue with the closure of bars and restaurants and other public accommodations. That was from the earlier executive order. That will extend to May 1st at 5 p.m. And we're authorizing the Commissioner of Education to implement our distant learning plan that is ready to start on Monday, the 30th, continue that till May 4th. So some of the things you're going to be asking, there are a million questions here. We're thinking about all of the things you're asking. And again, it all matters. I spent time this morning with Archbishop Hebda and the Catholic bishops, understanding that there is a health component, there is a mental health component, there is a economic component of this, there's a social component, and there's a spiritual component about understanding as life goes on, how do we continue to address all of those needs for Minnesota. So we're trying to think of ways to make sure that we're doing the best science on social distancing, but allowing you to live a life that allows those things to get done. So I'm just going to hit on a few. This isn't anything. You're still able to, of course, if you need to go to the doctor, safety things you need to do, of course you need to do that. Outdoor activities, be smart about this. Don't congregate together, but if you can get out and social distance and walk, that's good things. If you're running, please do so and stay away from one another, but those are things you can continue to do. You need to get out to the grocery stores. You need to get gasoline. Those things will still be permitted. We're not keeping you in your house. We're asking you because it's going to take cooperation and collaboration. Stay home. Stay home and do these things. Essential and interstate travel, when those situations come up, care of others, displacement, relocation. This is by all means not an exhaustive list, but it starts to give you some ideas. This does not mean you don't step out of your house. This does not mean that you can't do some of the things that keep life functioning on, but it does mean that we're getting more restrictive to get us to that 80%, which bends that curve to the right. And of course, workers who provide essential services. We use this, and the way they figure this is the cybersecurity and infrastructure. When we've gone through these things, whether it's a man-made disaster, whether it's an act of nature, or in this case now where it's a global pandemic, things that are deemed as critical infrastructure, healthcare, law enforcement, childcare, food and agriculture. Many of you out there are listening how you get added. And I want to be clear, if you are not on this list, that does not mean that the economic activity you provide, if you are a shop owner providing retail sales, you are a part of the fabric of this state and absolutely important. It's just that at this point in time, we're trying to reduce those activities the best that we can to keep things functioning. So your heat stays on, your internet service is still provided. All this that we're doing is to keep those of course, first line defense of firefighters, police, and then of course the healthcare workers safe, and buy them some time to get things stood up.